For those familiar with my channel, you'd know that if I get new information that disproves some of the things that I believe, I change my views. I'll state such in my videos. It'll usually be the first thing that I say. I'll be like, hey, I've changed my views on this. Sometimes I'll be like, hey, I'm sorry I viewed things the way that I did. My last video, I didn't say anywhere in it, hey, I've changed my views. So you can assume that the videos I've made over the past couple months, maybe few months, are things that I still believe now. I may have primarily criticized the right wing, and especially the Trump administration, but that doesn't mean that I think that what a lot of the left has been doing is good. I still tried to criticize, at least to some degree, the left in my last video. But to some people, that wasn't good enough. Now, there are a number of people who my last video is the first video you've ever seen of me. I suppose I should try harder to fit just about everything into a video, but it's hard. That's very hard to do. I don't condone or support the rioting from the left. I understand why they're doing it, but that doesn't mean I support it. That doesn't mean I condone it. That doesn't mean I say, hey, yeah, you go. Doesn't mean I'm going to, you know, say that I'm Antifa. I've specifically said in videos, you know, I am anti-fascist, but I wouldn't call myself Antifa. I don't want those connotations in my name, you know? I don't support cramming left-wing ideology down students' throats in colleges, in high schools. If a college or a school is getting federal funding or public funding in some way, they should be politically neutral, as far as I'm concerned. If you push political viewpoints on one side, then you need to equally push political viewpoints on the other side. And if there aren't sufficient viewpoints of equal value from the other side, then just don't talk about it. But you shouldn't be cramming, especially far-left ideas, down people's throats. It's just not right. I feel the same way about HR departments. No, you shouldn't be cramming critical race theory or critical theory or gender theory down everyone's throats. It's not right. These are divisive ideologies. These are far-left viewpoints. Most of them are based, at least loosely, in Marxist theory. Marxist theory is a far-left ideology. There's no getting around that. And I don't think we should be indoctrinating children into a far-left ideology. You can go, oh, well, it's truth. And it's just like, well, it's a way of breaking things apart, but it's not the only way of breaking things apart. And you can't sit there and call people bigoted or fascist or racist or sexist or homophobic or a whole number of names just because they don't want to buy into these ideologies. People have different thinking patterns. Okay, the left tip, people who have certain kinds of thinking patterns will gravitate towards the left, or they'll gravitate towards the right. The right wing tends to want order and tradition and working within systems that have been well established already. They tend to not like to break things apart in new ways. They tend to not like new ideas as much. But within the things that already exist, they do really, really well. They do great in those areas. And you know what? We need people who can do things great in those areas. People who gravitate towards the left tend to be into new ideas, even if they're crap, tend to not want as much order, tend to be a little bit more chaotic. They also tend to be more creative. They tend to think outside the box a little bit more. And we obviously need people who think like that as well. It's why, politically, it's why there's such an even balance between what you consider the left wing and the right wing. You know, we need both. You can't squash one side. So to cram a particular political ideology down everyone's throats, it does a disservice. It causes division. It's not right. Okay, I do hope that there's something that eventually comes up that stops these ideologies from being crammed down everyone's throats. I don't want it to be Trump that has to do it, because if Trump does it, it's going to be done in a very authoritarian fashion. And it is going to be seen as fascist. There's really no getting around that. You know, if someone on the left happens to do it, it won't be viewed nearly as badly. Now, I don't think Biden is going to stop this. I certainly don't think Kamala is going to stop this sort of thing. But I also don't think they're going to egg it on either. So I have a lot of problems with what the left has become. You know, I don't like the fact that people on the left, the way they've been bullying as of recently, past, I don't know, 6 or so years, could be a little longer, but it's especially went into place since Trump has been in office, is that you'll try to, if someone doesn't buy into these far left ideas, you don't just call them racist, sexist, homophobic, misogynistic, fascist. You don't just call them those things. You'll try to ruin someone's life. You'll try to get them fired from their jobs. You'll try to ruin their reputation. You'll sometimes even, you'll support trying to get rid of someone's ability to process credit. And you somehow think you're righteous for it. Somehow having this mindset that if you make someone scared to state their views, that they'll change their views. If you push their views underground, it won't be able to cause the damage. And it's just like that's all false. You push them underground, they'll fester more than ever, because they're not allowed to have it in the public sphere where it can be countered, where people can debate those ideas. You know, I think about how people on the left have talked about how wrong it is for a company to fire someone for having a left-leaning viewpoint. You know, there's horror stories of people being fired from their jobs for having a pro-LGBT sticker, having a some sort of pro-left-wing sticker on their car. Oh, we don't represent that. And they fire someone over it. Okay? That's not right. Someone shouldn't be able to be fired for having a particular political view. But according to the new left, it's okay to do that. It's okay to ruin someone's life for not buying into far-left ideological views. There's a lot to complain about with the left, but there's also a lot to complain about with the right. And it seems that if I ever criticize the right more than the left, there's this assumption that I'm just okay with everything the left does. I'm sorry, that's bullshit. I guess I don't know what more to say. It's going to be interesting watching the debates tonight, you know, with them having the cutting off the mic when the other person is talking thing going on. I'm wondering what sort of a shit show it's going to be. I have them set to record and we'll see what happens. Maybe I'll make a video going into some of the specifics that, you know, some of the highlights of the debates. Who knows? But it's going to be interesting nevertheless. Anyway, thanks for watching.